In this video, we're talking about lateral epicondylitis. Now, you might know it better as tennis elbow. You've probably heard of it because it's one of the most common overuse conditions in the whole body. But what is it? How does it happen? And why do we call it tennis elbow? Let's talk about it. Unsurprisingly, tennis elbow doesn't only happen in tennis players. It's an overuse condition, meaning it can happen to anybody. We tend to see it with repetitive movements, and in this case, repetitive movements of the wrist. Now, let's talk about some anatomy really quickly. The elbow joint is composed of three different bones. You've got your humerus, you've got your radius on this side, and you've got your ulna on this side. Now, this bony bump on the inside of your elbow is called the medial epicondyle, and this bony bump over here is called the lateral epicondyle. Now, the reason that's important is because the lateral epicondyle serves as the attachment site for a lot of the muscles that help bring your wrist up, kind of like this. And you can even feel it if you put your hand right on top of your forearm over here and you bring your wrist up. You can kind of feel your muscles moving around that region. Now, why is this important? Because the muscles that serve to bring our wrist up tend to originate from right about here, the lateral epicondyle. This is the region where we tend to experience pain when we do a lot of repetitive movements with our wrist, and this can often result in what we call tennis elbow.
Any repeated motion, I go, I'm gonna play tennis, and all of a sudden he goes, well, with the phone, I was like, oh my God, that kills me. So I wonder if anyone else is getting tennis elbow from taking selfies. Just let me know.
Like we talked about, we tend to see it a lot in people who do repetitive movements of the wrist. So we're talking racket sports like tennis, badminton, but then also in occupations involving a lot of use of hammers, screwdrivers, slicing food, painting, and even typing. Occupations involving repetitive movements of the wrist are at a higher risk of developing tennis elbow. So let's talk about specific symptoms. What do people tend to feel when they have tennis elbow? So the main symptom tends to be pain or a burning sensation right on the outside of the elbow. Now, you might also notice decreased grip strength. You might not be able to grip as much. And you're gonna notice pain with movements involving the wrist, specifically these type of movements where you're bringing the wrist up. Now, the next main topic of discussion is how do we get it better? Tennis elbow actually tends to respond very well to conservative therapy. So treatment consisting of rest, medication, and strengthening tends to help reduce the pain and strengthen the muscles that cause tennis elbow. Your physiotherapist will guide you through specific strengthening exercises and stretches to help make things feel better. Now, depending on the severity of your symptoms, people also tend to consider a tennis elbow brace, which essentially wraps around your upper forearm and helps to relieve your symptoms while you're doing tasks involving your wrists. And in specific cases, your doctor might even consider steroid injections to help relieve some of those symptoms. If your symptoms don't start to get better in between the 6 to 12 month mark with conservative therapy, your doctor might even start to consider surgery as a potential option. Tennis elbow is one of the most common overuse conditions in the whole body. A really good place to start is by talking to your doctor or your physiotherapist, who can do a thorough assessment to figure out if it actually is tennis elbow and not another issue causing your pain. As usual, if you guys have any questions, feel free to drop them down below and we'd be more than happy to answer them for you. All right guys, thank you for tuning in today. Hopefully you learned a little bit about tennis elbow, why it happens, how it occurs, and who it tends to happen to. We will see you guys again in the next video. Stay safe.